In this video, we will be talking about motors and how you can select the particular motor for your drone. So a motor is made up of a motor bell, that is the outer part that spins. So here, this outer part that spins is called as the motor bell. So motor bell has a bunch of permanent magnets attached to it. So as you can see here, the outer silver blocks that you can see spinning along with the motor bell, those are the permanent magnets. And inside, as you can see, there are some windings. So the windings comprise of the stator. So as you can see from the top, those windings are electromagnets, and that part is called as the motor stator. The stator is a collection of electromagnets made up of copper windings. The magnets are responsible for spinning the motors. The motors normally used in a drone are called as brushless DC motors, short for BLDC. So unlike a DC motor, they have three wires coming out of them, as you can see here. So this is a BLDC motor and there are three wires attached to it. So these three wires control three sets of electromagnets on the stator. The spinning action is a result of turning these magnets on and off very rapidly in a sequence. We will demonstrate using an animation how this happens. There are also brushed motors available, but brushed motors have a brush mechanism, and that mechanism tends to break after some time. So we don't use them much in RC applications. So this here is a brushed motor. So they tend to be useful in smaller drones like that. To select the right motors for your drone, first you have to estimate the weight of the drone. Then add some extra buffer, as it is always better to overestimate than to underestimate. The thrust produced by all four motors should be at least twice the weight of the craft. So for example, if this craft was to be of 1 kg, the motor should produce at least a thrust of 2 kg. So in case of a quadcopter like this one, having 4 motors, each motor should produce 500 grams of thrust. Let's now look at attributes of a motor. So first we'll look at motor dimensions. When buying a motor, you'll see a few numbers mentioned on the motor. So first number we'll look at is this one. So as you can see here, it says 3508. So X and S are to be ignored, only look at the number. So those letters are usually the model of the motor. The first dimension, the first two digits, that is 3-5, represent the diameter of the stator. So it is the diameter of the stator that is inside and not outside. And the other two digits, that is 0-8, is the height of the stator. Again, the inside part is the stator, and the height of the stator is 0.8 mm in this case, and the diameter of the stator is 35 mm. So we'll see another motor. So this motor here is a 2205 motor. So therefore, in this case, the diameter of the stator is 22 mm and height is 0.5 mm. The next thing we will look at is the motor kV. So it is also mentioned on the motor. So as you can see here, kV is 700. So what is kV? kV means the RPM per volt. This motor has a kV rating of 700. So this means that for every volt applied to it, it will spin for 700 revolutions per minute. So if you apply 1 volt to this motor, this will spin at 700 RPM. Let's look at this one. This motor has a kV rating of 2500. Therefore, this one will spin 2500 revolutions if you apply 1 volt to it. kV is just a rough estimation and not the exact value. So smaller motors tend to have higher kV. So in this case, we saw this is a smaller motor as compared to this one. So why does it have a smaller kV and a bigger one has a lesser kV? This is because this motor is big. And to complete a single revolution, it will take much longer than a smaller motor. This is just like the wheels of a car and a truck. So wheels of a car are smaller, and hence the car tends to move faster. But a truck, even though it is slower as compared to a car, it can lift bigger things. So since this one is bigger, this particular motor will be used in a drone, which is useful for carrying big things, maybe a spraying drone or something like a cinema drone or a big camera underneath the drone. Motors are designed to spin in a particular direction. Because in a drone, two motors should spin clockwise and other two motors should spin counterclockwise. Some motors are designed to spin in a particular direction. In reality, it doesn't matter which direction the motor spins, but a motor is designed specifically to spin in clockwise because of these nuts. So when a drone is flying, it can produce torque and make the nut loosen up. The propeller would just detach itself and fly away. So since this motor is particularly designed to spin in clockwise, this nut on top will tighten in that particular direction, preventing the propeller from getting loose. So similarly, we have a different one here. So this convention is usually followed. A black nut is used to represent a clockwise spinning motor, and a counterclockwise spinning motor is represented by a silver nut. Another number you might see on the motor, which you can ignore, is something like 12N14P, which means that N is the number of electromagnets and P is the number of permanent magnets. So 12N will mean that 12 electromagnets are in the motor, and 14P will mean that 14 permanent magnets are on the motor bell. Electromagnets tend to be in multiples of 3 because the motor has 3 wires, and any two wires will control a set of electromagnets. So it can be 12, 18, something like that. When buying a motor, it is also important to look at the motor mounting pattern, because this will be mounted later on your frame and it has to fit perfectly on the frame. As you can see, there are mounting holes present on the bottom side of the motor. So you should make sure that these coincide with what is on your frame. So in case you are building your own frame, then you don't have to worry about this because you can make the holes however you desire. Next thing, when selecting a motor, the most important part is to look at the motor spec sheet, which we will be seeing on the screen now. This is the motor spec sheet. It will be available under the motor web page that you are buying the motor from. Here you will find that there is a diagram of the motor showing various dimensions of its components. The one thing you should see here is that these mounting holes. So these mounting holes should coincide perfectly with the frame. Otherwise, you'll have a problem in mounting these motors on the frame. So check the dimensions. As you can see here, these two holes are 16 mm apart and these two are 19 mm apart. So this seam should be present on the frame. Next, under the diagram, we'll find this table. So this is the thrust sheet or the thrust table. In the first column, you'll see motor type, that is, this particular motor is of 2205 size, having 2300 kV. Now there are two sections made of the table. So voltage, there is 12 and 16. So these values here are what you get when you apply 12 volts to the motor. So 12 volts means 3S battery. While here, these values are what you get when you apply a 16 volts, that is a 4S battery to this motor. And this is the recommended propeller size, that is 5045. Now let us look at the other columns that are on the table. So first thing is the current draw. This means that when you start the motor, the minimum current it will draw is 1 amps. And as you start speeding it up, the current draw will keep on increasing, and at the max, it will take 20.7 amps. Note that this is the current draw for one single motor. And since on a quadcopter, there will be four motors, all four of them will be drawing 20.7 amps at max throttle. Next table, you have the thrust. So this tells you that at 1 amps, the motor will generate 62 grams of thrust. Similarly, at 3 amps, it will generate 162 grams of thrust. And at the max, you will get 712. For 4 motors, you multiply this by 4. 700 multiplied by 4 is 2848, which is almost 3 kg of thrust you will get. So this is the efficiency and power. So
These are not required for selecting parts unless you are going deeper into the efficiency and you want to increase the efficiency of the drone. Speed can also be ignored. So this is just the RPM of the motor at this particular current. At max, it will be spinning at 20,000 revolutions per minute. Similarly, we have the table for 16 volts. As you can see, the max current for 16 volts is 29.9. That is almost 30 amps, and it generates a thrust of almost 1 kg. This maximum current value will tell you which particular ESC you should select. If you have decided to use a 3S battery, then you already know the ESC values that you should use. So you should note down this max current drawn. If you are using a 4S battery, then you should note down this value. So later in the ESC section, we will be learning about how to select the ESC depending on what is mentioned in the motor spec sheet. From the motor spec sheet, you found out that you can choose the battery voltage depending on the thrust you get. So if you want more thrust, then you go for a 4S battery. If you want lesser thrust, you go for a 3S battery. And you should also consider that you won't always be flying at full 100% speed. You will be somewhere around maybe 80% or so, around 50 to 80% maybe. So you will be getting thrusts of this much. So from here, after calculating the thrust, you can get the thrust to weight ratio. If you have the estimated weight of the drone, then you can easily calculate the thrust to weight ratio from this data. So as you can see, that the motor spec sheet is the most important thing that you should look at before building your drone. And if in case the motor spec sheet is not available on the product page, then you will at least find the maximum current values given. That the page will tell you that the motor supports particular voltage at max, and the max current drawn at that voltage is 30 amps, and the max thrust produced is 1 kg, something like that. So that is it about motors in this video.